trapped here.
I am trapped. Yeah, I'm trapped. Just. And again, you can see where the mud came up, but that was just a wave. And again, the wave was because of these guys off-roading. It just pushes the water up. It wouldn't be this far. I grew up down here in Palm Springs. I've never seen it this bad. But one of the things that exacerbates it is you got these guys four-wheeling over here in the desert. You're not supposed to be off-road anyway. But all last night, they're coming through here in their four-wheel drives. And all it did is just make big waves and made this stuff just twice as bad. Are you part of the news?
Oh, dang.
I'm digging the truck right now because we got stuck. We got stuck. We were trying to come through here. Like, we seen the rest of the cars doing it, but so we joined along. But I think it's a blessing. It's cool. It's fun. It's just mud and digging. It's cool. There's a lot of downsides to everyone, like looking at the hurricane, but. We don't receive weather like this. I think we should look at it as like, hey, you know what? Let's look at the brighter side of it, you know?
Damn.
Yep, that's what I said. My dad though, this is his truck and he's kind of mad right now. But I told him like, it's fine. Like, I'm doing what I have to do to get it out right now. Like, I don't mind.
Oh, look at that!
Reports thus far indicate that as of right now, there have not been any deaths or significant risk of injury. The city mobilized, including opening the most emergency temporary shelters for unhoused Angelenos to provide relief from extreme weather since 2020. And we will continue to address these issues. Now, it's not to say that many Angelenos have not been impacted by this storm, whether they woke up without power or were unable to get through streets due to flooding and mudslides. Our commitment to you is that we will approach our recovery with the same intensity as we approached our preparation. As skies clear, the Department of Water and Power crews have already mobilized to return power to Angelenos. As you know, sometimes damage can occur in the hours and days after a storm hits, so Angelenos should continue to stay vigilant. The city family will continue working around the clock to respond, and we will need your help. City workers are working virtually today, obviously, except for first responders, but tomorrow there should be no reason for everyone to be back to work in person.
At around 7:30 last night, we responded to a flooded intersection in Sun Valley where five vehicles were stranded. This required our firefighters to rescue one person from their vehicle. Thankfully, no one was injured. This serves as a very good reminder for all of us to avoid driving through flooded streets, and especially if you cannot see what is under the particular surface. A relatively small amount of moving water can sweep a vehicle away. We have not encountered any significant debris flow incidents, but our saturated hillside still can pose a threat for mudslides. All city departments will continue to assess the impacts of the storm. We will be conducting our damage assessments and entering the recovery phase for this event. As Angelenos venture out on the roads this morning, we urge you to please continue to be cautious of hazardous road conditions. Stay informed, slow down, and be alert for the hazards, like our downed power lines, like we keep talking about, and our flooded areas.
I am very glad to say that Hilary no longer meets the thresholds as a tropical cyclone and is therefore resulting in the cancellation of all tropical storm warnings for Los Angeles County, Ventura County, and elsewhere across Southern California. This is definitely a very good situation as we go into the recovery phase that has been mentioned. And there is still going to be some water on roadways. There's still going to be the remnant debris flows and rock slides and mudslides that we need to be careful of. But we are past the brunt of the impacts at this point. We are past the time period where we were getting prepared for, but we still need to be cautious. We're going to continue to have some light rain showers affect our area, but we're not looking for any new areas of flooding, just a recession of the waters where they had already built up.
You know, under the best of circumstances, you pull everybody together, you prepare for the worst, and you hope for the best. And so the fact that it wasn't the catastrophe that had been anticipated, we are very happy about, but had it been, I have the full confidence that our city family was prepared to respond.